Hello and welcome to the episode 94 of What a Fab Day. I am your host, Simon Mas. Some highlights of the day include a most unusual concert, a record really hard to beat, and an attempted jam session with Jefferson Airplane. On the 4th of April 1961, we have another top 10 club night for the Beatles, featuring Pete Best on drums, in Hamburg, West Germany. 1 year later, in 1962, the band, still with Pete Best in the lineup, performed a lunchtime and an evening concert at the Cavern Club in Liverpool. In 1963, the Beatles had their second consecutive BBC radio recording session, their third in the week. Operating from the BBC Paris studios in London this time, between 11 a.m. and 2 p.m, they recorded the third session for the side-by-side program. The Beatles' performance of Too Much Monkey Business, Love Me Do, Boys, I'll Be On My Way, and From Me To You was aired on the 24th of June, from 5 to 5:29 p.m. The show also featured one of the recordings of Side by Side by the Beatles and the resident Carl Denver Trio, recorded on the 1st of April. For more information, you might want to check out episode 91 of What a Fab Day. I'll Be On My Way is of particular importance, being the only recorded version of the Lennon-McCartney composition that will be officially recorded and issued by Billy J. Kramer and the Dakotas. After the session, the Beatles travelled to the Roxburgh Hall in Stowe for an engagement with the male-only Stowe School, a prestigious public school. It was an unusual concert for 1963 in that its audience watched it without a single screen. It came to be booked after manager Brian Epstein had been contacted by one of the pupils, a Liverpoolian called David Moores. Impressed enough by the boys' approach, Epstein agreed to the engagement. On the 4th of April 1964, the Beatles achieved a peculiar and almost impossible to beat record on the Billboard charts. In this week's Billboard Hot 100 chart, the Beatles were featured in 12 places, with a song on number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 31, 41, 46, 58, 65, 68, and 79. This was in part possible because their early singles had been put out by different record labels on the US market. Capitol Records had 6 entries, VJ 4 entries, and Tully and Swan had 1 each. The rundown of the songs is Can't Buy Me Love on number 1, Twist and Shout on number 2, She Loves You on number 3, I Want to Hold Your Hand on number 4, Please Please Me on number 5, then I Saw Her Standing There on number 31, From Me to You on number 41, Do You Want to Know a Secret on number 46, All My Loving on 58, You Can't Do That on 65, Roll Over Beethoven on 68, and Thank You Girl on 79. As if this wasn't enough, the chart also featured 2 tribute records, We Love You Beatles by the Carefrees on number 42, and A Letter to the Beatles by the Four Preps on number 85. If this doesn't scream Beatlemania to you, then I don't know what might. In 1967, between 7 p.m. and 12:45 a.m, at the EMI Studios in Abbey Road, George Harrison was with George Martin and Jeff Emerick to oversee the final stereo and mono mixdown of Within You, Without You. At his request, The Sound of Laughter coming from the EMI sample tape Volume 6, Applause and Laughter, was attached at the end of the master track. The song was also edited to remove about a minute worth of material from the final result. The edit can be heard 2 minutes 23 seconds into the song, both for the mono and the stereo mix. Meanwhile, in the USA, Paul McCartney with assistant Moll Evans had landed in San Francisco. Paul and Evans were invited at the Fillmore Auditorium to watch Jefferson Airplane rehearsing. After that, they joined the band in Oak Street, in a flat Marty Balin and Jack Cassidy shared with the band's road manager Bill Thompson. They tried to jam together, but Paul had problems playing the band's right-handed guitars. After that, Paul and members of Jefferson Airplane smoked some weed together. Allegedly, Paul refused an offer of DMT to be mixed to his pot. Finally, in 1969, Glyn Johns was once again at the Olympic Sound Studios between 7:30 and 11:30 p.m. working on a new mono mix of Get Back and Don't Let Me Down for the Beatles' next single. This concludes another episode of What a Fab Day. Tomorrow, we'll see the Beatles receiving their first silver disc. For the moment, I wish you a good day and a fab continuation.
Simon Mas, music you love.